What the heck is vape tongue?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
Welcome to Medical History Mysteries. And this week we're talking about vape tongue. What is a vape tongue?
So vape tongue is something that I saw published in an article in a news magazine regarding the dangers of vaping. And I've had a lot of questions from people about it. You know, I've got vape tongue. My friend says I have vape tongue. What's vape tongue? Okay. Well, vape tongue really has two points of origin. One, it's due to the xerostomia that's often induced by vaping. So the xerostomia doesn't allow you to spread, saliva allows you to spread food particles around your taste buds. So therefore you can taste your food. Well, vape tongue, due to the xerostomia that's induced by vaping, means you can't spread the food particles around and what you're eating doesn't really taste as good. But there's also the problem of irritating the tissue and sometimes even scalding the tissue, because we are well aware that vape pens generate high temperatures, you know, somewhere over 250 to 300 degrees Fahrenheit. So you're drawing in, right? You're inhaling that vape. So that vape mist aerosol doesn't have enough time to cool off between the end of the vape pen and your mucosa. So you end up scalding or burning or somehow injuring your tongue. And because of the nature of the vape and the aerosol, the temperature still is pretty high when it gets to the back of your tongue where a lot of your taste buds are located. And so the association there is, I don't taste anything anymore. Nothing tastes good anymore. Or actually some things taste awful. So this potential for dysgeusia can also occur with vaping. And remember that, as I'm sure our viewers have heard me say in the past, vaping is dangerous all on its own because of the things that can be contained in vape.
So vape tongue is about the loss of taste, not how it looks or any sort of soft tissue changes. People are now in, so COVID's over. We're not talking about taste and smell anymore because of COVID, even though some of us are still dealing with it. But here we are. Now, people who are vaping all the time are losing their sense of taste as well. Well, does it come back?
Well, that's the thing. I think a lot of people realize that if they were to stop vaping or at least, you know, avoid it for a certain period of time, that they would find that their xerostomia clears up, if you will, to some extent, that their taste does return. But, you know, vaping itself is addictive, and it's really hard to stop vaping once it's become part of your lifestyle. Now, we haven't talked about what's in the vape. All we've talked about is the act of vaping. But for example, if cannabis were to be included in this discussion as far as I'm vaping cannabis, well, we know cannabis causes morphologic changes to tissue. We know that cannabis can cause xerostomia all on its own. We know the act of vaping can cause morphologic changes, as we said, because of the high temperature. We also know that vaping can cause pathologies, right? Because it's the simple act of vaping plus exposing our tongues and oral mucosa to the components of cannabis. Here's where a lot of people lose me and say, what are you talking about? Cannabis is natural. What would be so harmful about vaping cannabis? But realize, as I'm sure our viewers have heard me said before, cannabis is cannabis, meaning I don't know anything about this stuff. Where was it grown? And what kind of soil? Were there heavy metals in the soil? Were there PCBs in the soil? Were there pollutants and other toxins? Were there fertilizers used, insecticides used? Vape pens and oils that are used in vape pens look pretty pure when you look at them. Clear liquids. But there's nothing pure about that oil because it could have all those contaminants in it. So we don't know what we don't know about vaping as far as morphologic changes and tissue changes, especially to the tongue, since the tongue and the palate get the greatest brunt of the vape as it's coming out of the vape device.
So in my mind, I put vaping on the shelf with smoking and cannabis use. It's kind of like three things that I kind of lumped together. But now as a dental professional, we have another part of another conversation to have. So obviously this is part of our oral cancer screening and our soft tissue exam, but now we can talk about some functional changes that can take place as a result.
We go to great lengths to talk to our patients about tobacco use and cessation of tobacco smoking and use of tobacco products. But I have to say, for all of our newer professionals out there, the ones who've recently graduated from dental programs and hygiene programs, you're going to be the first generation of dental professionals that not only have to worry about tobacco and its use in patients and the systemic effects of tobacco use and the oral effects of tobacco use, you're also going to have to deal with the effects, both systemic and oral, of vaping. Because we only know what we know now, but we're only 20 years into vaping. The first vape pen was introduced and discovered and invented in 2003. You know, we've only got about 20 years experience. So in another 15 or 20 years, we're going to start to see a lot of the effects of vaping that we saw with the use of tobacco. And who knows what those effects are going to be, because we don't have yet enough perspective to know what we don't know. But that's why it's important to be ever vigilant now as a younger dental professional, because you'll have younger patients who are users of cannabis and vaping to follow them more closely and treatment plan accordingly in the future.
And we have such an opportunity to be a good influence on habit changes and, you know, behaviors. So, you know, you can do it. We can do it. We fight the good fight every day. And there's great reason to do so, because here we go, another new sign of using vaping. So thank you for that update.
Thanks, everybody.
All right, everybody, for Medical History Mysteries, we'll see you next week.
See you all soon. Thank you.